One of the points is when we started in the bank in geothermal, and I came across a study by the WWF, and it's a fantastic document about a climate vision 2050. The idea with that study was to kind of look at the technologies that could, at one point, help us kind of to derive the energy that we need to continue growing, and at the same time cutting back carbon emissions at the same time. Both things that we need to do. And in that study, basically, the WWF ranked those technologies by the capacity to kind of provide energy and at the same time cutting back carbon emissions. So they came up with a ranking, and actually the ranking is a lot much larger, but the interesting thing is that geothermal was ranked as the number two technology. Number one being energy efficiency, and actually cutting back on energy use, and number two was geothermal. And the main reason for that was the role that geothermal energy could play, particularly in heating. Power maybe not as big, but particularly on the heating side of things, and that's something in the whole carbon emission and climate change debate is a hugely huge factor. So if you look at Iceland and the use of geothermals, I mean, a lot of people connect it with maybe a swimming pool and power generation, but the most usage of geothermal in Iceland is actually coming from space heating. So about 45% of geothermal use today in Iceland kind of goes into space heating. And that shows kind of the important role of geothermal in Iceland. I could give you now all the speech about kind of that, how further more important geothermal is, but in power generation, geothermal only represents about 29%. So it's actually not that big.